When we think of racial injustice, we think police brutality or the criminal justice system. But what about our air and water? Environmental racism. It's about policies and practices that discriminate against communities of color by making them live near landfills, sewage plants, and other polluting facilities. And while poverty has a lot to do with it, the leading environmental justice expert told me this.
Racism trumps class. Even middle-income African Americans are more likely to live in more polluted neighborhoods.
In fact, one study found that Black Americans making $50,000 to $60,000 a year are more likely to live in polluted neighborhoods than white Americans who make just $10,000 a year. Flint, Michigan is a textbook case of environmental racism. It's where 100,000 residents have been poisoned with toxic water contaminated by high levels of lead. Why? Because the state was trying to save a buck. Flint is around 57% Black, with 40% of its population living in poverty. Residents protested the dirty water for over a year, but were ignored. And that's how environmental racism plays out. Minority communities have much less political clout, so regulators can, and often do, ignore them. And not far from Flint is Detroit, where 83% of the population is Black. It's home to the most polluted zip code in Michigan.
Zip code is the most powerful predictor of health. And all communities and all zip codes are not created equal.
Southwest Detroit is surrounded by a lot of industry, like salt mining, steel production, tar sands oil refining, and coal burning. And that's meant that 1.6 million pounds of chemicals enter that community yearly. Not coincidentally, Wayne County, where Detroit is, has the highest number of children's asthma cases in the state. But look, environmental racism isn't just a Michigan story. It's an American story. Take, for example, Louisiana's Cancer Alley, an 85-mile stretch along the Mississippi River. It's known for its over 200 petrochemical plants and a high rate of cancer, mainly among Black residents. So, is there anyone protecting folks from environmental racism? Well, there's supposed to be. The Environmental Protection Agency has a special department called the Office of Civil Rights, but in its 22-year history, the office has never formally found a single case of discrimination. In fact, more than 90% of communities that make complaints find them rejected or dismissed. On top of that, The Guardian newspaper recently revealed that U.S. authorities across the country are deliberately distorting water tests in cities like Detroit and Philadelphia to minimize the reported amount of lead in the water. Environmental racism, while not always the most visible form, is also widespread. So, when is enough enough?